great time, and at the end of that luncheon, I knew that Rick Avery had a book. No question in my mind. And as I worked on the book with him, I was amazed to find out how much he has done. And it started out with his school, and it went on to, I joined the military, and it went on to, I became a cop, I became a police officer. And then after that, I met John Travolta, and I got into the movie business. And then after that, I decided I was going to take up helicopter flying. And I was going to fight forest fires in California, and I was going to work on film, and I was going to be the camera guy in the helicopter. And in all of that, too, I'm a martial artist, I own my own karate school, I'm competing, I'm doing all these things, and it doesn't end. And then, of course, the last couple of years, he won not only the national, but he won the world boxing championship, which is quite an accomplishment. And I can add appreciably to that. That's why that book over there is so thick. It's a great book, and I suggest that you pick one up on your way out and be happy to sign one for you. It's a great read. Now, what I found out from Rick, besides him being a marvelous human being, one of the easiest people I've ever worked with, always arrived with a smile, always had, was fully prepared, was he was just an extremely positive person. I never saw him in a bad mood. I never saw him complain about anything. And what I learned about him, I learned near the end. You'll remember this, but I'm going to tell you what I found out about him. He said to me near the end, he said, "Would you like to see my hero room?" And those of you who have visited his home know what this hero room is. I hadn't seen it. It's a beautiful room. It's got neon, they look like neon lights to glass, plexiglass cases in a room that just goes round and round. And it's memorabilia. And I thought, he said, his hero room, who's the hero? Are these his heroes? What is a hero room? I've never met anybody with a hero room. And then I watched him. And he went in there like a little kid. And he lost himself in it. And he said, "Oh, and this is from Blues Brothers. You see that hat, and you see this? Oh, and look at him." And I'm filming this because I thought I would use some clips later. And he went around like a little kid and just loved talking about his hero. But that's only part of the story, because what I found out about Rick in the end of the book, and when you read it at the end of the book, you'll know what I'm talking about. I thought that that hero was his heroes, which it is. But it's more important than that. Rick, when he was in high school, lost a wrestling match, a bad wrestling match. And then it changed your whole life, that wrestling match that you lost. And he spent a long time after that looking for mentors, looking for heroes, looking for guidance in his life, looking for what we all do, who come into Kempo and come into martial arts, is security and a safe space. And he found it in Alan Gibbs for a while. He found it in your mother. He found it in other people. But eventually, what Rick did is he found it in himself. He did. He found it in himself. He became his own hero. And the way I know that is last year he came down to Wisdom Elementary School, where my wife is a school teacher of third graders, and he was at a Wisdom Elementary career day, and he talked to the kids. And I saw some video of Rick talking to these kids, and he said, "You can do anything in life if you believe it." And he's a man of positive affirmation and a positive attitude. And that's what has made him his own hero, and it's why he's been able to accomplish everything that he has been able to do. He became his own man. And that is a tremendous story. That's what his hero room is about. He is the hero room. And I want to thank you, Rick, for sharing your life with me. And I greatly value your friendship. Thank you.